Mcilween's eight sisters carried the coffin from his home, themselves flanked by masked men in paramilitary uniforms. The funeral followed the pattern set for the eight other dead hunger strikers. The volley of shots, almost drowned by the noise of circling army helicopters. And the long, slow parade of thousands of people through the streets of the town. The priest's criticism of the IRA during the service led a few to protest and walk out. The IRA, he said, should have called off the hunger strikes after Bobby Sands became an MP. As it was, leading figures of the Republican movement this afternoon laid Thomas Mcilween in his grave. Mcilween was imprisoned in the maze after being found responsible for firebombing this shop in Ballymena in 1976. He was convicted of the manslaughter of Yvonne Thompson, who died in the explosion. Her death left three children motherless, children who the people of Ballymena now want to send to London to confront the leader of the Greater London Council, Mr. Ken Livingstone. Mr. Livingstone met McElwee's mother before he died and said that he supported the hunger strikers.
We come up to the grave here frequently, as we are doing today here. And as you can notice by Dennis, the elder boy here, who was involved, he was in the shop that day and was blown out through the door onto the street with his hair on fire. And how anyone could turn around and give credit to somebody to do such a thing is beyond my knowing.